Hey, don't move them all to one side. I gotta have it even.
I'm trying to get it even.
No, you got that one moved all the way in and this one not. Don't move them all the way in. I don't want the tires right on. I'm gonna move that one over this way, son. Yeah, I can't understand how to correct it the way it's turning. Make sure I don't fall off my damn ramps. I think I need to go that way just a little bit. Is it a lot I need to go off or just a little bit?
Just a little bit, your tires like this much off.
Oh, that's fine. As long as I'm on the ramp, it's all right.
All
right. I can't turn that much. Hey, go all the way back to that, oh, never mind. Yeah, just reach up high because I can't see you. That good?
Shit, how far do you want to go? You touch the wood? You're good. Reach it.
Is it flat in the front?
It's flat on the front, but it's not touching the back. That's why I say go like this.
What about now?
It's about flat. Go a little more down, pitch it a little more back.
Yo, that was scary as hell driving and turning. I couldn't tell if I was going straight, sideways, or what. Freaking out.
You. I'm freaking out. Damn, I gotta get this guy to go straight.
It was hard to turn straight.
I'm a little bit to that side, but oh well. Ain't that much.
All right, let's grab these ramps so I can back up and then throw some chains on this and get gone.
Hopefully the bulldozer is easier.
Bulldozer on there, no?
Yeah.
So why are you taking the ramps off?
It's not here. I gotta go to Irvin.
Oh.
That's why I gotta get going.
Just set them to the side.
You put the after we take that off, I'll put it back on. Not in there.
Oh.
Just set it behind you. Put that back in.
All right, we're on the next load. Didn't really get a lot of filming done loading this load. Once we get over there to drop it off, I'm gonna see what I can do to get any type of recording done. But I got a wheel loader and I got a bulldozer. I did drive the wheel loader up onto the trailer. First time I drove one. It was a little scary going up my ramps and everything because of the way it turns with pivots. But I'm walking around, show y'all the securement, and I gotta get on out of here and get over to my delivery. Still got about 150 more miles to go. I got a chain up over the bucket on the front. Pretty much bunch of my chain pockets. On the front here, I'm going to my chain pockets, and I got an X in the front. Holding nice and good, pretty much right against the wheel, so that it's not going anywhere. No way to get any movement going forward. And on the back, I didn't want to pretty much cross my chains and have them going across the light or anything like that, so I just kind of went straight down with it, both sides. This little dozer, I got a chain over the bucket, which on the blade, which probably didn't need, because I don't think that thing's going to move really at all. And then on each side, you can see the tie down points in there. I've got a chain going down to my chain pockets. And on the back, I went off the pin in the middle. Just put a chain pulling each way. Both nice and tight. See all this excess chain. Chains are way too long. Had a lot of excess chain from pretty much that chain that is just so short, just going from here to there. And this one is going over the blade, wrapped it all up. These ratchets are actually not even touching the chain. This is all loose chain that's kind of in there. But yeah, that's what I got. Big wheel loader. And I didn't have any covers for the exhaust, so I just put some duct tape on it. Because I never hauled machinery like this before, so I didn't need any cover. I might look into getting the cover eventually, but yeah, it's been a cool little load. I picked it up in Texas and Dallas when I was at home, and I'm running up here to the auction in Pennsylvania where I'll be dropping it off today, and then we'll see what we get from there. But like I said, I'll try to record some of the unloading and throw it, which is you guys later.